So, ask question, what I know, or you should ask anything. Go on.
Maharaj, firstly I would like to thank you for making yourself available for this interview. The first thing I'd like to ask is, you have mentioned recently that originally this planet was called Bharat Varsh. All the continents were connected.
Connected?
Yes.
Yes.
And that originally there was one language, or an original language, Sanskrit. Could you please explain this?
Yes. It is true, because it has been written in our Shastra, in our epics and Vedas and everywhere, that Manu was the first son of Creator Brahma. And Manu used to speak in Sanskrit. And his one book is called as Manu Smriti. It is also in Sanskrit. So he used to speak in Sanskrit, and his children's sons and sons after sons, they also used Sanskrit. And also, I know that from various scriptures that in Indian language, as Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam and other languages, all have come from Sanskrit. Sanskrit language is full perfect. And we see that it is fit for computer also, most fittest language. And also we see that European languages, that most of words are like Sanskrit or derived from Sanskrit. So we can tell that originally Sanskrit was one language of the whole world. And later on, from the Sanskrit language, so many changes little came, like Irani language, like Farsi, like other, the original language in Europe, like England, Germany. So many words are like same as Sanskrit.
So, Maharaj, before the advent of Lord Krishna, according to the scriptures, there were many asuras usurping the human race, creating a false gods sort of mood. And then Krishna had to advent to rectify, to fix the situation. And then after Krishna left, we came into Kali Yuga. Would you like to explain a little bit about the asuras and Krishna's advent?
We know from our scriptures that from very beginning of creation, Madhu Kaitav, there are so many big demons. And after that, in Treta Yuga, from Vaikuntha, Jai Vijay came as Ravan Kumbhakarna. And before this, Hiranyakashipu and Hiranyaksha, very big demons. And after that, so many demons came. Also in the time of Ramachandra, he has to come to punish demons and to kill demons like Khar, Dushan, Ravan, Kumbhakaran, Meghnad, and so many. And after that, or those who were killed by Ram or others and other demons came in Dwapar before Krishna came. And they were ruining our Vedic culture and knowledge. They used to think that this body is myself. They never thought that we are part and parcel of Godhead. And so they want to test whole world, thinking this is our kingdom or mine. And thus they were ruining this thought that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead, or Bhagavan is Supreme Personality of Godhead. And thus ruining this Siddhant, this established truth, that all the souls in this world are part and parcel of Supreme Personality, and we are eternal servant. So they thinking the body myself, they used to test all the ladies at that time who were beautiful, taking wine and meat and all things. And they were ruining all Vedic culture and these things. So Brahma himself, the creator of this world, he prayed to his master with earth in the shape of cows and all demigods, that if you are not coming and establishing pure religion of soul, Vedic culture and knowledge, then everything will be ruined. So Krishna came. At that time, there were so many demons in the shape of Kshatriya kings, emperors, like Duryodhan, Kansa, Dushasan, Shakuni, Karna, Jarasandha, Maidano, and also Kaljavan, Pandrik Vasudev, and there were so many. All were enemies of this religion. So Krishna had to come. But real cause was not this. By Vishnu it has been done. But Krishna, the time of Krishna to appear in this world was at that time. So he came to this world to take the taste of Braja Rasa, love and affection. And secondary, to kill these demons and establish Atma Dharma, what is written in Gita. Jada jada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyatthanam madharmasya tadatmanam sijamyam parinitranaya sadhunang vinashaya cha duskitam dharma santhapnarthaya sambhavami jube jube. So Krishna came for this thing, and he first killed so many demons like Putana, Akhasur, Bakasur, and Pralamba, Charun, Mushti, Kans. And after that he went to Dwarka and he killed Kaljavan, Jarasandha. And after that, in Mahabharata battle, war, big war, lakhs and lakhs demons were killed by Arjuna and Bhim. But really, Krishna killed all. It was seen from outside that Arjuna or Bhim were killing them. But actually, all the demons were killed by Krishna himself, because he saw He has shown in his mouth Vishwarup, universal shape, that all are in his mouth. under his teeth, and all are dead. So he told that nimitta matra bhav sabya sachi, that how you should be only
instrument.
I've killed them. So Krishna killed them. And he established Brajadharma for which he has come prominently. He came in Braj and he played with all the gopis, all the gopis, with cows and cowherds and everyone. And he showed this, that this is the real dharma of all the conditioned souls are liberated. So,
Maharaj, Krishna lived on the planet for 125 years, according to the scripture. And then when he left, started Kali Yuga. And it is described that his palace in Dwarka sank beneath the sea. And according to the books of Genesis and the science of the floods, these were about exactly the same time. So was there a partial annihilation when Dwarka was sunk and then we moved into Kali Yuga?
We have so much faith on Srimad Bhagavatam, because Srimad Bhagavatam is an authentic book other than any book. I have not read any book of Jesus Christ or the Bible or anything, but I have read Srimad Bhagavatam, and it has been told there that Krishna will be 125 years age in this world, and after his going to Golok Vrindavan, Kali Yuga will come. After some year, when Parikshit, in the time of Parikshit Maharaj. So when Krishna left this world, Kali Yuga wanted to come and to affect whole world. Kali means kalaham lati iti Kali Yuga. Kalaham means quarrel, without no reason. All will quarrel themselves. So Kali Yuga wanted to enter, but Parikshit Maharaj saw a strong king, that at his time Kali Yuga could not enter in this world. But he prayed Maharaj, Parikshit Maharaj, that please give me some place, because our all brothers, Satyayug, Dwapar and Tretayug, they have been given chance to be in this world. So why I should not? So please be merciful to me to be here. So you should give any place, I am in your control. So he told that you can go. And where there is gambling, where this cutting of animals, all these things, Dyutang, Panam, Istriyam,
Suna,
Jatra, Adharmo, Chaturvida, where there is gambling, where is cutting of animals, where there is connection with male and female, which is not Vedic,
legal,
and to drink wine and all these things, smoking and other things, you can be there. But he was not satisfied. He told that you should give anything where four things are there together. Then he told that you can be in wealth, that is in gold. Where there is gold, all things will be there. So Kali went in them. Where there is wealth, where is gambling, and where cutting of animals and drinking wine and all, he made. And all over world he spread, and began, then all were began to quarrel themselves. This is Kali. So sometimes in the end of Kali Yuga, Kalki comes, one of the manifestations of Krishna, and he controls and he kills all the demons. But in the Yog, Kali Yog, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sachinandan, comes taking the beauty of Radhika and inner mood of Krishna, and he preaches everywhere Harinam Sankirtan, by the influence of Nam Sankirtan, there no need of coming Kalki. So by the influence of Harinam Sankirtan, most of the demons, their thought becomes transforms, and they become pure by this. So Kali will gradually go up, but Sankirtan will also go up. So fortunate jivas connected with Harinam Sankirtan easily. Now you see that in whole world Nam Sankirtan is going on. And so many devotees are coming and they are chanting Krishna name, whether pure or impure, but they will be liberated. Only the thing is that if they are making some offenses, then they will not be. Otherwise, anyhow, they are telling, uttering Christ, Krishna, Krushta, Krishna. Anyhow they are doing, they will be liberated. So we think, and Shastra tells that Kali Yuga is most important yuga than others. Then very easily, without doing any lot of austerities, we can be liberated from this world very easy by telling, by uttering Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Hare Ram. So many of the devotees, they want to come in Kali Yuga, so that very easily by practicing Hare Krishna, and they will also achieve Golok, Vrindavan and Brajaras. In other yugas, there is no scope to go to Golok, Vrindavan and to test this Braja Rasa, especially Unnato Ujjwala. Only it can come by the associates of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, very easily chanting name, and one can realize this Gopi Prem, Braja Prem, and easily they can be. So we think that this Kali Yuga is most important yoga among all yogas.
Maharaj, in Srimad Bhagavatam, Lord Buddha is forecast. He is
Buddha. He is
Buddha, yeah.
And so are all the avatars. They are all mentioned.
Yes.
And then there is mention of Shaktivesh avatar.
Shaktivesh avatar.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm now asking, inquiring about His Divine Grace, Srila Prabhupada.
Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami. Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, he is inquiring.
Oh. It is, has been told about also that what Vedas and Shrutis and Puran have told, Krishna is not only bound to be like that. He is out of control of Vedas. So he will think better to descend in the rush. He may come at any time according to his free will. No restriction, no binding, no control on him. So sometimes if there is no written that in Kali Yuga any Krishna avatar, no manifestation of God, but yet he can come lakhs and lakhs times, though it is not written, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, but it has written very deeply hidden. So we know that Shaktyavesh avatar, where the power of Krishna is in a some little
degree,
it is manifested there. So it is called Shaktyavesh avatar, the power of Krishna. Like Parshurama is Shaktyavesh avatar in Treta Yuga. Also we see that Buddha may be Shaktyavesh avatar. But there are so many Buddhas. In Srimad Bhagavatam, it is written that Kikateshu Bhavishyati. Kikatesh means Gaya. The original Vishnu Buddha, he took birth in, especially in Gaya. And he only told that those who are killing animals in sacrifices, I don't agree with them. They should not do. Ahimsa paramo dharma. They should not try to kill any animal, any bird or anything. So this, he was Vishnu Buddha. But after so many years, 2000 years, near Himalayas, Kapil Vastu is a place. Here a person took birth and he was Gautam. And he wanted to know the really why the persons are all becoming old, suffering so much, and they die. So he went to Gaya. And in the same tree where Vishnu Buddha has taken birth, he went there. And he wanted to know by meditation, because there is so much appreciation of meditation in Indian Shastra. So he began to meditate. But he did not knew the practice, how proper, what is the proper
process.
Practice. Our Indians saints and Vedic culture, meditation of God, any shape, and those who is very powerful, we can meditate like our mantra, Prachodayat. You should come in my heart. Om Bhurbhuvasva Tatsavitur Varanam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo. I am meditating, Prabhu. You should mercifully come in. This is the process of meditation. But he did not follow all these things. Oh, he only took his mind from other things and he began to see that with his own practice. So nothing came. Then he told that there is no God, no Vedas, no all these practices, bhakti, yoga and everything. Everything is zero and everything has come from zero, and in the last everything will be zero. And he went to preach this. This is not Bhagavad Buddha. He is Gautam Buddha, a jeev. Even not very powerful. So in Vedas, it has been told for Shankar also, Mayabadam Asasastram Pachannam Baudham Uchyate Mayobihutam Devi Kalav Brahmana Murtina. To
bewilder.
The persons who are not devotees, always they want to test world. For them, Krishna has told me to come in this world and to cheat them. So they should not worship Krishna. Otherwise, they will use bhakti yoga also for their own gain. So, Mayabad. What Shankar told, it is also Mayabad. Though he was a Shaktavesh avatar, but his teachings are, we don't, all Vaishnavas, Ramanuj, Madhvar, Sam, everything, everyone has told that we should not follow all these things. So he was Shaktavesh avatar. Buddha original was himself Buddha, but he, this Gautam Buddha is not Shaktavesh avatar or anything. Swamiji was a very authentic Acharya. He came in the line of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rup Sanatan. We know that it has been told in our epics that if there is no Shakti of Krishna in anyone, he cannot preach. So all the acharyas, like Rupa Swaminathan, we have heard that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Prayag, he
inspired
his whole shakti in Rupa Goswami, and then he preached. Similarly, he gave his shakti, Nityananda Prabhu gave that power in Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami. That I am writing, what I am writing, Nityananda Prabhu is doing. Similarly, for others, Bhakti Vinod Thakur is the incarnation of manifestation of Gadadhar Pandit Srimati Radhika. So all acharya, being a power of Krishna, they can preach. Otherwise, never they can preach. This preaching power comes from Krishna originally, from his Shakti, Ladini and Sambit. So he must have that Shakti. Otherwise, he could not have preached very soon, in a very, very small,
little time.
Everywhere he went. So we think that he was like that. He was empowered by Krishna. I have told it about 15 years before I told this thing, that he was like a Shaktavesh. Otherwise he cannot preach like this. A common person cannot preach this thing. What I am preaching? From where I am preaching? From where? Who is doing? I am not doer. I am not preaching. This comes from, originally from Krishna. In the line of disciplic line it comes. So he was surely a Shaktyavesh like this avatar, and he preached, no doubt.
Maharaj, can you please explain the significance of going to the sacred sites like Mathura and Vrindavan and Mayapur and Puri?
What is the importance of visiting the holy places, Mathura, Vrindavan?
Jesus, yes.
Or anyone?
I have heard and I have full confidence that he must come. He came in his boyhood and he entered from Hindu Kush and that Khyber Ghati valley, and he came Mathura, Vrindavan, and he visited all the places, and then he went to Varanasi, and from Varanasi he went to Puri. And from Puri, I don't know where he went, but I think that in any way he has returned. When he came in Mathura and visited this, he was so much affected by the Vaishnava religion. And that is why he has so much faith, and faith in God. And when he went to Varanasi, he was somewhat affected by Mayavadi Sannyasi. Then must be God. He has so much belief in God. But that God of Varanasi, by which he was influenced, he took in his heart that he is shapeless, powerless. But he could not reconcile. So he went again to Puri. And he saw Jagannath Baldev Subhadra there. And he was associated. He was there for some time. And there he knew some Vaishnava theory. And then he returned. And some mixture of all. But bhakti is somewhat there, prominent. He has told that God has not saved. But he was angry. That God has shaped, because God created man after his own image. So there are so many lines in Bible that we are bound to admit that Godhead has shaped. Because if anyone is son of God, If anyone is messenger of God, then God must have his shape. Without shape, this world cannot come. So everything has been accepted in Bible also, and he has accepted. So I think that he has accepted all the Vaishnava theory, but somewhat amalgamated with some Mayavad. But it is prominent that he has belief in God. Yes.
Thank you very much, Maharaj. Thank you
very
much.
Thank you also.
Dandavan.
Hare Krishna.